Begin by finding a position for your body that feels comfortable for you. Maybe it's sitting in a chair or on a cushion. Maybe it's lying down. In any case, allow your body to get comfortable. Make any changes that you need to at any time that allow you to prioritize comfort in your experience. And from here, gently allow your body to relax. Notice if there's any muscular tension that's present for you at this time. And invite your body to relax, to loosen, to let go. And if you'd like, if it feels good for you, invite a gentle, easy smile to your face. It doesn't have to be a huge grin, just a gentle, easy smile. Allow yourself to enjoy this configuration of your body, being comfortable and relaxed, with a gentle, easy smile on your face. And begin to involve your mind. Reflect in your mind on things that you're grateful for, things that, when you think about them, summon a sense of gratitude for you. These could be things that are unique and special for you at this time of your life, or totally ordinary things, things that we may have come to take for granted, like food or water. or a place to sleep. Reflect on whatever it is that makes you grateful. Tell yourself in your mind about these things. Whatever it is that makes you grateful. And if any feelings of gratitude arise for you in the body, notice that and really enjoy them. Very good. Now, bring to mind someone who's relatively easy for you to feel love for. Your easy to love person or animal. This could be a friend or family member, perhaps a child or a pet. Could even be a fictional character. In any case, consider who that might be for you. Someone for whom you have a simple, uncomplicated love. And visualize them in your mind's eye, imagining them being happy. Perhaps smiling or laughing or playing. Perhaps recalling a happy memory that you shared with them. And use this exercise of visually imagining them being happy as a way to cultivate an attitude of well-wishing towards them, an attitude of care and friendliness and love. You can use the same image of this easy to love person over and over again, or use many different images, creating varied scenes and different situations in your mind's eye. In any case, use visual imagination as a method for cultivating this love for your easy to love person or animal. Again, to whatever extent this exercise generates felt experiences of love in your body, notice those feelings and enjoy them deeply. Savor those feelings of love. Continue to practice cultivating love for your easy to love person or animal for another moment. Very good. Now, bring awareness into your heart, your emotional heart center, the region of your body around the center of your chest. Feel that area of your body. Notice what the region of your body, around the center of your chest, your emotional heart center, feels like right now. In particular, looking for any sensations that seem to be associated with emotions, with an emotional quality. For example, love or happiness or sadness or fear or anger. Any emotions are valid, including no emotions. Just notice what that area of your body is like right now for you. Attend to this region of your body as if you are paying attention to someone in conversation, someone you cared about and loved. Give yourself and your heart the same attention, presence, and love that you might to another person. Listen to your heart. Listening to your heart is first and foremost a quality of attention or presence, of care and respect. Giving yourself the same genuine attention and love that you might to another person that you care about. And practically, you give yourself that attention, that care, that love and respect by feeling the region of your body around your heart center and noticing what's present for you. Simply attending to those sensations, noticing them, feeling them, and allowing them. Without needing or wanting them to be right or wrong, pushing them away or grabbing onto them. You're attending to these sensations with equanimity, Simply allowing. But this equanimity is, in fact, a kind of love. Simply to be present with yourself, without an agenda, without needing yourself to be different. Just noticing. And bringing this quality of attention to your heart allows for a real kind of listening, listening to your heart, making space for the feelings that are present for you to say something if they want to send you a message, to express themselves. Perhaps in words that you hear in your mind, or in some other way. This expression from the heart may or may not happen. There's no need for it to happen. But by feeling your body, your heart center, you're making space for it to speak to you. To send you a message that you need to hear. Continue to practice listening to your heart. Good. Now, take a moment to look back on this practice period. Remember what it's been like for you. And in particular, see if there are any lessons you might discern, things that would be useful to remember for future practice periods. And as you're ready, at your own pace, you can come out of the meditation.